So what should you do? Low intensity cardio, high intensity cardio? Which one burns the most fat? Which one is gonna get you shredded in the shortest amount of time? Hey guys, it's Tim Mariello. I'm the fitness and supplement expert for I'llPumpYouUp.com online supplement store here at Muscle City Gym in Clearwater, Florida. You know, low intensity cardio was always a staple for bodybuilders for decades. You know, same old boring thing. You get on a bike, you get on a treadmill, you're on there forever, man. 45 to 60 minutes, sometimes 90 minutes of just redundant, boring cardio, all right? Then came high intensity interval training, also known as HIIT. And I tell you what, I've done 20 different bodybuilding contests. I've done low intensity cardio for a very long time, but the last couple years I've incorporated HIIT and it's been a huge success for me. It's been a hit. So what exactly is it? What is the interval in interval training? The first thing you need to know is you want to jack up your heart rate pretty high. Not too high, of course. You don't want to hurt yourself. You don't want to get a heart attack or anything like that. But the aim and the purpose of HIIT is definitely to get somewhere between the 160 beats per minute to maybe even the 170 beats per minute. One of the most popular high intensity interval training exercises is definitely sprints. But sometimes it's raining outside. Sometimes people don't like to do sprints outside. Sometimes it's snowing. Whatever the case may be, there's always option two, and that's sprints indoor on a treadmill. And it's quite simple, right? HIIT is a great way to get your metabolism shooting through the roof, and it actually will last for several days. Not one day, multiple days. Your metabolism will be very, very high. Here's how you do a sprint on a treadmill. First off, obviously you want to get warmed up and stretch, right? Put your feet on the side of the treadmill. You want to increase the speed to something where you know you're going to get a decent sprint in, right? This is how it works. You're going to do a 60 second sprint and you're going to rest for 60 seconds. You're going to sprint for 60 seconds, you're going to rest for 60 seconds. You're going to keep doing that until you reach about 30 minutes, all right? But actually, you're only going to be running for about 15 to 16 minutes tops, all right? Again, you want to put that speed real high. It's very, very important and critical that you get your heart rate up, all right? So I'm not going to sprint real fast for you guys. I'm going to talk to you, but I'm going to give you an example of how it's going to look like on a treadmill. All right, so I've got the treadmill running. Let's try to do about seven, okay? Ready? One, two, three. All right? Run for a minute. All right? 60 seconds. In between, if you can, check your heart rate. Make sure you're good to go on that. All right? After you do 60 seconds, hop on the side. Rest for 60 seconds. Make sure you take a good rest, catch your breath, check your heart rate. All right? So 60 seconds is up. Again, get back on there and start sprinting. Guys, once you do this for 30, 32 minutes, I tell you what, 6 to 8 weeks with a good diet, you'll see it's a lot better than low intensity cardio. It's not boring, it's exciting, and it'll keep you motivated. All right, guys, for more fitness tips, check out our YouTube channel, youtube.com/I'llPumpYouUp.com. Also, follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and be part of the community and join our forum. All right, guys, we'll catch you later. See ya.